Okay guys, so we're getting straight into that gunfight. And this is one of many gunfights that is extremely intense, but not very long. So first you're gonna start off by getting rid of the shotgun's helmet. Then you're gonna come back to take down that dude. And then after, you're gonna take down the shotgun. Of course, that was cutting it really close because I could have died. Probably one hit and I was dead. Then you're gonna make your way up top there, take down this guy, and then you're gonna go take down the grenade launcher that you're gonna use to take down the other shotgun. Pick the grenade launcher, get back up, look down, shoot your name. And then we're gonna go around and kill those remaining enemy. Be careful of their shotgun. Headshot. And there's another one. We're gonna jump on his face. There you go. There's one guy left. We're all gonna also jump on his face. And there you go. This is the end of the encounter. Also, I won't be speaking until we reach the first fight in the next chapter, considering the first part is only puzzle and I have nothing to say about puzzle because it doesn't require any skill but just knowledge of where you're going, you know. So that's about it. I will pick up on the next fight, guys.
Coming through.
Something's wrong. Really good.
It's passing through.
Hey, Sully. I think we can squeeze through here.
That'll work. Jeez. Long way down.
You okay back there?
You keep your pace. I'll keep mine.
Yeah, well, at least you got a great view, right? Okay, let's see what we got.
This place is in much better shape.
It's right in the middle of the city.
This is a very tall clock tower.
Yes. Yes, it is. Bet.
Scorpion, guy with a large pitcher.
Zodiac. Look, there's Leo.
Ah, Taurus.
Four signs.
Four bells, way up there. These things in the middle of the floor look like locks.
Got it. Let's go ring some bells. This is definitely the place. Call Sam.
On it.
Scorpio, Aquarius, Leo, Taurus.
Voicemail. Hey, Sam. Looks like we're at the right tower. Call us. They don't have the best coverage in this city.
Well, no reason to wait. I'll be right back.
be damned. Check it out, Sully. The clock still works.
Yeah, I noticed. Try not to get tangled in those gears up there.
You bet. Watch your fingers, Nate.
Should I be nervous?
No, good. Trust me.
Where have I heard that before?
Scorpio. But Avery was a Scorpio. Aquarius? Always nice people. Okay, got it.
Hey, Sully, any word from Sam?
Not yet.
Nah, he's probably fine. Just forgot to charge his phone. Fun? Wow. This is a nice view. Change the time here. No. Jesus. Oh, there you are. Sure hope you're doing okay out there, Sam.
Okay, Sully, I made it. This is gonna be loud! Sully, heads up! Sorry! The handle broke!
Yeah, better than drop anything else in my head, alright?
I'm gonna have to bring it myself.
Here we go.
Jesus Christ.
Hey, Sully. Oh, shit. At least I got the door open, though, huh?
Hey.
Hey, look. The coin. You want it?
Yeah, sure. Why not? Let's see what's down here.
Fingers crossed for piles of gold and jewels. Sam, finally, you okay?
Just searched my town. I got nothing.
Yeah? No. We're definitely in the right place. Make your way over here.
Are you serious? Okay, I'm on my way.
He's coming.
Good. Sully.
Way ahead of you.
Whoa.
Hey, are those our boys?
Yep. Founders. Founders of what?
Worst scavenger hunt ever?
There are Avery and two sigils. These are a little different, though.
Yeah, they got those star patterns on them.
They turn, but... Whoa.
Okay. Should we go look?
Yeah, just a second.
More pirate symbols.
Adam Baldridge, Anne Bonny, and Christopher Condent. I mean, there's too many permutations.
I say we see where that door leads. Still hoping for some treasure, yeah?
Hey, look, I was right. Baldridge, Bonny, and Condent.
Splendid. But why are they here in the first place?
Well, let's find out. Oh, that mustache. Hey, look at these stars. They're just like the ones on the Avery and Two sigils in the other room.
Yeah, you're right.
That's right. Condent went by Billy One Hand. Here's another one of those star patterns.
Yeah, but this one's different than that first one.
Oh, yeah. Good catch.
What do you think?
Those Avery and Two sigils. The stars on those lined up, remember? I bet these line up, too.
Hmm.
That's... They are,
You don't know, do you?
Hey, there were a lot of pirates out there, you know?
So we're stuck?
No, we're not stuck. Would you give me your phone?
What, you're gonna phone a friend?
Close. Text a brother. There.
You know, these are actually some nice paintings. If we don't find the treasure, maybe we could sell them to a museum.
Let's find those star patterns. Hey, you still in the tower?
Yeah, just climb back down. What's with the picture you just sent?
I'll fill you in later. For now, just tell me who's who.
Well, the dolphins are Richard Want, the trident is Joseph Farrell, and the two hands with the pearl is William Mays.
All right, great. Stay where there's good reception. I might need your help again.
Nathan, did you find the treasure?
No, not yet, but I got a mechanism to solve here. I'll let you know.
Books, globe. This Want guy looks like a scholar.
Hey, Richard Want. He was the captain of the dolphin.
Whew. Looks like he and Baldridge were in a best wig competition.
Hey, Sully, give me a hand.
You got it.
Thanks. Is it straight?
Who the hell cares?
Well, I care. There.
God, look at Farrell's face. Looks like he'd rather be anywhere else. Okay. So who do we have here? You know, I'm honestly shocked you don't know this stuff.
Don't. I do. I just want to make sure Sam knows. You know, because he likes to feel useful, that's all.
Uh-huh. Of course. Shit. What happened here?
A torch probably fell or something. Come on, let's see what's left. Huh. No name. This guy's get-up looks Moorish. Found the stars, but who are you? Huh. Yazid al-Basra.
Looks Indian.
Close. Muggle.
Wait, not the Muggles, the ones Avery robbed?
Honor among thieves.
Yeah, like that's ever the case.
Edward England.
Stout little fellow.
Not sure yet.
Maybe send it to Sam?
Really?
Hey, you're the one who said he's the pirate expert.
Okay, that's
just
one.
Just saying.
And two? Last one. All right.
Okay, so the next fight is about to happen here, and after, of course, we're gonna run away from the armored truck. And that part can be pretty annoying. Well, not as much as the encounter where you're sliding on the ground, but I will be talking about that once we reach that. because this encounter here isn't that bad. It starts right here. You see the enemies will be here, so what you can do is go straight up, cover yourself right here, okay? And be ready for the fight. Don't be scared to shoot the enemy multiple times. Don't be scared to go around either, because you can do stuff like this. Okay, after move a little forward, and then there's gonna be a dude that will rush you, like right on the corner here. So now make sure you you keep staying undercover, and then take down those dudes there. And be careful, because you will take massive damage from the turret around. After, I'm gonna use a grenade. And this dude, I don't know if there's still one left. Now I'm going back for the spear grenade. And when you see that you have grenade available, like this guy's, make sure you use them. Like here, I throw one, I don't know, usually there's three guys. So I at least killed one. I killed the second one, and then the third one. Then we move forward here to make the truck change position. And then we're gonna go see if we can pick up more ammo or bullet of any kind, actually. So more AK, here a power 45. And there, at this point, you spawn more dude. And there's still gonna be some dude inside after, but I'm gonna get rid of them. See, there's dude inside back there. And yeah, this is annoying, so I'm gonna throw a grenade and at least get rid of one of them. And now the goal after this, after we go get more, maybe bullet. And here I didn't think he would be able to aim at me through the shelves inside that little shop. Roll, hide here. Be careful if you took damage, because you see I should have let my health regen. This is the safe way to play. So once you get inside, go straight up for the stairs. Don't worry about the rest. There's gonna be two guys on top, one coming from the left and one at the right of this door. So headshot, and then we hit this guy right here. And after this, we're getting into, well, like, more like a, not a car chase, more like I'm running away in a car. So here was the key to press start, just in case, you know, the checkpoint would fuck up, because this is a checkpoint, but actually it didn't, because it's not, at this part here, at this little part, it's not live commentary, because I had to stop at the checkpoint, and this is too annoying to resume live commentary at this point, especially if there's a chance that I fail again. There's certain encounter that I won't do live commentary. So here, you want to be really patient, guys. There's no need to rush. Wait, let your health regen and keep going, because if you don't, okay, I guarantee you will get killed if you keep going, because you take massive damage from the bullet of that armored vehicle, so you have to be extremely careful. And again, you just have to outrun the truck, and that's it. So they didn't say you have to go really fast or anything like that. Again, the truck will follow your movement. And seriously, that was like perfectly clean laundry. You focus about that when you're getting chased by a fucking tank like that, even if it's not an actual tank. It is some type of thing for me. So then now you keep heading down here. Just be careful. And once you reach down, I will give you like a really simple trick, guys, so that you don't have to go all around the market. You can simply go straight up where you actually have to go if you take a right at the end here. Because the truck here forces you to take a right, but what you do is you just keep going. You go straight there, because if you take a right, you're gonna end up coming back and going up the stairs to come back straight up to that point where I just jumped. So if you want to avoid that, do what I just did and go straight up for the stairs. And yeah, and I like the route here, actually, you know. Well, yeah, we got a 4x4. It's good on all type of area, well, pretty much. And he's like, let's see the truck pass that, and boom! And here, you gotta hurry up to take a ride, guys, because if you take too long, also, you will die and take massive damage. And the roof in this city are really useful to absorb the shock of a Jeep. I mean, what are the coincidences here? Okay, so this part here, okay, you're just trying to catch up with Sam, but after, okay, once you start sliding on the ground, you will see an edit that I made, and I didn't even try to be subtle because I checked a couple of crushing wall two of this part. I wanted to see if there was someone who was doing this whole encounter like in one go, like I did after basically I reached the checkpoint. And I didn't see anyone do it anyway, not in the popular walkthrough, to be honest. And that shows me that this part is really hard. The reason why is because when you're sliding, okay, you don't have any cover and it's really easy to die. So that's why you gotta combine switching up truck, having a really good accuracy to get rid of the enemies and not take too much damage. So you will see when I get there, it's like in literally 20 seconds. And I'm going to pick up, well, continue from that encounter that I will try to give you a couple of tips and tricks to get through without restarting at every single checkpoint. Crap! Okay, so this is the last part of the video, and you can clearly see the little edit I made there because I actually restarted that encounter, I think, maybe 2-3 times, and here I would have died. Like, logically, I got the Jeep right in my face, I would have died. So at the beginning, what you want to do, guys, is literally spam the pistol, because for some reason, until you reach a certain part, you have infinite ammo. So after you get rid of all these guys here, you're gonna want to try to, like, go and get back on the truck, you know, grapple on the wire and get back on the fucking truck. After that, you gotta be ready. There's gonna be a Jeep that will be on, well, the right side if you're looking back, on the left side if you're looking in front, and you're gonna get rid of it. After, there's gonna be a motorcycle shooting you. And by the way, this is always the same thing, guys, when you restart from the beginning of the encounter. And the loading time for that specific encounter is really annoying, okay? Trying to switch shoulder here. Okay, so now I'm gonna let my L regen, and we're gonna switch truck. This sometimes can be really annoying, honestly, the grappling and shit, and you see here I'm like extremely close to dying. Actually, my health is like, it's pretty bad. I can't say like it is really low because there's no health bar, but I can literally say if I'm close to dying. Okay, so now get rid of the first Jeep. We're gonna get rid of the other one because at this point we fire too much bullet on this Jeep to be switching Jeep. And here, really close again, my health really low. That's why I'm saying this encounter, guys, is fucking hard. Like, I'm not joking, it's really fucking hard. So here, I'm gonna switch to the Jeep because this is gonna allow me to take down some bike. And of course, you wanna be taking down a couple of bikes and Jeep before switching. Because if you switch when there's still a bunch of bikes and other Jeep, that Jeep that you're in, okay, at some point, it's gonna break. And if it's break while you're still in it, you explode and you fail, okay? This is the story here. And that's why, look, you see, my thing is almost starting to fail, and my health is really low right now. And honestly, I really thought I was going to die there. I really got lucky that I managed to take down those fucking Jeep without dying. And even that dude, I mean, there's still some motorcycle down there. They could have been shooting at me and all, you see? So this is, like, honestly crazy, this encounter, in my opinion. Crazy hard. If you do it all in one go, it's really not easy. So we're gonna take down that Jeep. And then after, I don't recall if I switch a Jeep again or anything. Yes, I do. And there you go. This is the last switch, though. Because you see the big truck, like, broke. So this is the last part of this. And of course, there's a couple of motorcycles left around. And man, I love when they jump on your Jeep, honestly, because that's just another reason to knock them the fuck out of the ground. Like, oh, go back there, you fucker. Oh, that must have hurt his back, man. Fell right on his back on the ground. Okay, so basically once you reach this part, you're good. Even if the Jeep is smoking, like there's black smoke after this, it's gonna be pretty much running away from the Jeep with your brother on his motorcycle. Because right now, he's not gonna up on the car. You know, he's stubborn. That's why right now we crash and then we're ready to get the fuck out of there and take down those guys. So this is the end. Well, this is the ending part of that video. I hope you guys enjoyed as usual. If you enjoy, again, make sure you drop a like to support me. I always appreciate people who support me. Who wouldn't? So, that's about it, guys. Take care. See you on the next video. Peace out.
No blimmin' way he could have survived that.
Why chance it?
That's not good. Holy shit!
Holy shit.